Hi and welcome.
In this video, you'll learn what it takes to become a backend web developer. So, what does a backend web developer actually do? And what are the technologies you must master to become one? Do all the courses and tutorials available now make you feel overwhelmed? This video will give you an overview of your backend web development path.
For more in-depth research, click the article below. The article will also include resources and will go deeper with every subject.
As a backend web developer, you'll be implementing server-side business logic. You'll be implementing user authentication and working with databases. You'll be responsible for the server-side web application logic and the integration of the work that front-end web developers do. Backend developers usually write web services and APIs, APIs used by the front-end developers and mobile application developers. That will be the job of backend web developer.
But before we go on the backend development path, there are a few things you need to know. No matter what path you select, you need to know the basics of the internet. How does it work and what is DNS, HTTP, HTTPS and SSH? You need to know the basics of the terminal, of the command line. The rest you will pick up on the way. Also, you need an editor to write your code with. This will depend on the language you select, but the common editors for beginners are VS Code and Atom. No matter what you do, you need a version control. Life will be hell without having the versions of your software. You want to be able to revert and move step by step. Okay? These are a must, no matter if you are a front-end or a back-end developer. And then you can start.
The first thing you need to do is pick a back-end language to learn. For the beginners, I would recommend you pick one of the scripting languages. Since JavaScript works both on the back-end and the front-end, Node.js would be a great start. Another option, based on popularity and usability, is Python. It's also an easy language to learn.
Here is a graph from Stackoverflow Insights. Stackoverflow is a go-to page for every developer. Here you can ask questions, find solutions. And each time I have a coding problem, I paste it to Google, and Google more or less finds a solution for me on the Stack Overflow. And this is a graph showing how technologies have trended over time. I'm comparing scripting languages like Python, PHP, Node.js, Ruby, and TypeScript. TypeScript is really a superset of JavaScript. And as you can see, Python is gaining popularity. You cannot go wrong by choosing Python. PHP is going down. I started with PHP like 20 years ago, and WordPress is built with PHP, for example. Node.js is a great choice since it is a server-side JavaScript. You learn one language and you can use it both on the front-end and the back-end. Perfect. If you look at Google Trends, the situation is similar. Python is leading and PHP follows, and Node.js is behind them. Last are Ruby and TypeScript, which does not mean they are less important languages. In my opinion, it is not the question of the best programming language. Each has its perks and is best at different jobs. Your job is to find the best tool for the job. That will make you the best developer. When you have already mastered a scripting language, try a functional language. Here are your choices: Scala, Haskell, Erlang, Clojure, and Elixir. Google shows a similar trend. Scala, Haskell, and Elixir. There are other popular choices. As said, you need to pick a language based on what your project is. Windows technologies are losing their popularity. As you can see here, C# and .NET are losing its momentum. Other options are Java, C++, Kotlin, Dart, Go, and Rust. And here are the Google results. Java and C++ are first. Go to my article to get to know more about all these languages, yes? Just to give you a feeling, here I compare Python, Java, Node.js and Scala. These were the popular ones. Can you see why this would be a smart choice to start with? But first, start with a scripting language. So your choice could be Python or Node.js, okay? When you pick the language, you start with the basic syntax. You learn about data structures and algorithms. You get acquainted with design patterns, standards, and best practices of the language. No matter what kind of project you are doing and what language and tool you are using, keep in mind two strategies. The first one is KISS method. KISS method stands for keep it super simple. Do not overcomplicate when it is not needed. What you could also have in mind is MVP, that means minimal viable product. First do the simple example of code functionality, then add to that. Do not overcomplicate anything. Which goes well with the next method. That is YAGNI. It means you ain't gonna need it. That is often true. So my friends, keep it simple, yes? As a web developer, your life will be a mess if you don't use any kind of version control. Git is a must. I cannot imagine programming without being able to revert and move on branches. And whatever you do, try working on real-life projects. If you need to find ideas for projects and you would like coding challenges, you can write to me. To get to know a language, you need to use a language. When you learn a programming language, you don't memorize it, you use it. You develop projects small and simple first. When you do your projects, you'll be using package managers. In the case of Node.js, that is npm, or you could use yarn. Python has pip, PHP has composer, and Ruby has gems. Learning a framework will be the next thing on your list. A framework is a foundation on which you build your program. It is a set of libraries you can use. Or better, it is a skeleton on which you build your app. There are several for each programming language. The most popular one for Node.js is Express. Express has a lot of utilities and features, making development easier. Django or Flask are the popular choices for Python. And Ruby on Rails is for Ruby. PHP has Laravel, and Java programmers prefer Spring. For every application you will build, you'll need a server. Many companies nowadays also use cloud solutions. The servers you need to be familiar with are Apache, Nginx, AAS, and Tomcat. Cloud providers you can use are Google Cloud, Amazon AWS, IBM, Azure, Heroku, and DigitalOcean. As a backend web developer, you need to know at least the basics of security and networking. You need to know what DNS is, HTTP, HTTPS, FTP, and SSL. So, how to practice on real-life projects? If you have no ideas for projects, you could try contributing your code to an open-source project. You can try to make and distribute some packages or libraries. This will promote you as a developer. So why not contribute to an open source project? Once you are creating your software, you will find the need to test it. You will get familiar with unit tests and integration tests. You will learn what mocks are and what stubs are. In almost every software, there will be a need to store and read data from somewhere. I recommend learning SQL databases first. The popular choices of SQL databases are PostgreSQL, MariaDB, Microsoft SQL, and MySQL. Most backend developers sooner or later need to develop a web service, an API. One of your projects could be to create a sample RESTful API. You can create a list of your favorite programming books, and then you create a CRUD method. CRUD means create, read, update, and delete methods for the data. You will also understand REST and how to make RESTful API. When you have large volumes of data, you will use a NoSQL database. NoSQL database choices are MongoDB and Cassandra. Almost every app also needs user authentication and authorization. Authentication means confirming your own identity, while authorization means granting access to the system. Authentication is the process of verifying who you are, while authorization is the process of verifying what you have access to. OAuth is an authentication protocol you must know. It allows you to approve one application interacting with another on your behalf without giving away your password. You also need to be familiar with JWT or JSON Web Token, basic authentication, and OpenID. I think about here you are ready to get the first junior backend developer's job. To stand out of the crowd, there are some technologies you can get familiar with. So, what is the roadmap from here? Many apps nowadays, like chat for example, are real-time. To create real-time apps, you need to learn about WebSockets. When your apps become data-heavy, you will soon need to cache that data. Popular caching options are memcached or Redis. And when you write modular code, your pieces of software will need to communicate with each other. And here is where message brokers come in. They provide asynchronous communication between different components of your software architecture. They use the publish-subscribe paradigm. Popular choices are Apache Kafka, RabbitMQL, and Apache ActiveMQ. Also, search is a super important feature. Search engines available to you are Elasticsearch, Solr, Sphinx, and Apache Lucene. ElasticStack is the name of three open source projects: Elasticsearch, Logstash, and Kibana. Check that out too. For data query and manipulation, GraphQL is becoming more and more popular. For many, it is an alternative to RESTful APIs. Optionally, you can also check graph databases. Graph databases to check are Neo4j, Azure CosmoDB, and OrientDB. When your apps are growing, you will want to make them scalable. You will want parts of your code to be isolated and run independently. You will want your deployment process to become easy and your system stable. This is why you will use Docker and containers. To manage containers and automate deployment and management, you will use Kubernetes. But this will be on your path. Do not get scared of the big list of technologies. You can start at the beginning and go one by one. You don't eat an elephant in one day, and you also don't learn web development in one day. You start with choosing a programming language. Then you learn about variables, ifs, whiles, whens, and algorithms. And then you become an alien to the rest of the human race. But no worries, it's super fun and never boring in web development. Pay is also way better. There are many options to work from home and get extra benefits. Basically, being a web developer has its perks. You get to kill bugs all day, push to master and do a git blame. You can also kill a child of a fork and not get arrested. And yes, you get to know to understand these kind of jokes. Not a thing an average person can do, and get paid for it. Let me review the backend learning path again. You start by picking a language, a scripting language like Python or Node.js would be a preferred choice. Then you learn the basics, data structures, and design patterns. You learn a version control system like Git, and you start working on real-life projects. You learn about package managers. And you proceed with a backend framework. You will need to know about servers and cloud providers. And at least basic knowledge of security and networking is needed for a backend developer. To practice your knowledge, you can contribute to an open source project. You will learn about unit and integration testing. Then you start working with databases. Start with SQL databases. As a project, you can develop a sample RESTful API. Then you can learn a NoSQL database like MongoDB. And almost every app will need to have authentication and authorization. As a fun project, you can do a real-time app, like a chat, for example. With data-heavy apps, you will need to learn about caching. When your app is becoming more complex, you will make it modular. Parts of your software will communicate with each other via message brokers. And search is super important. Use the best tool to implement it. An alternative to RESTful API is GraphQL. To make your app scalable and parts of it isolated and manageable, you will use Docker and Kubernetes to manage containers. Yes, I understand it's a lot. Go one step at a time. Focus only on one next thing. You will not understand how stuff works until you start doing it. You need to use the tools and practice to get better understanding. The best way to do this is by working on small projects or assignments. You can start off by doing simple projects like a simple blog with a photo gallery. You can proceed with a resume builder or a simple project management app. If you are at the beginning, all this must feel overwhelming. You know I'm a self-taught developer too. I know how it is. There are two things that helped me most on my developer's journey.
The first thing was that I started working on real-life projects super early. I was learning my first programming language, and I applied for some jobs in the first months of learning. And you know what? They gave me the job. At that time it was a student job, but it enabled me to learn way faster. The other thing that helped me most at the beginning was getting a mentor. He guided me in the first months of learning. He is still a good friend. Having someone to tell you where to go, how to think, and how to solve problems is super important. If you need ideas for projects and you need some coding challenges, you can write to me. I will be selecting the most determined students among you. I will help you to get into VIP development as soon as possible. My email is jana@youcan-courses.com. Are you ready for your development journey? It's the best time, it's never perfect. So start now! And subscribe to my channel to get more tips and tricks. Have a great day, bye bye!